know your local hospital's emergency room is covered under your insurance, but what about the doctors or specialists who treat you there? For many, that's the source of sometimes expensive and shocking bills.
John L. Frank Dunna had to have two emergency brain surgeries after he hit his head and suffered a brain bleed. He thought his medical insurance would cover the costs. Instead, he was hit with more than $90,000 worth of bills.
I was shell-shocked.
What John didn't know is that about two-thirds of emergency room doctors are independent contractors. They may not be covered by your plan. Doctors can bill you for what your insurance doesn't cover.
Do your research before an emergency happens. Contact your area hospitals and ask if they take your insurance. Then ask your hospital of choice whether the ER doctors there will take your insurance too.
Ambulance, lab services, and special equipment can also fall into the out-of-network category, potentially costing patients thousands of dollars. Consumer Reports says if you get out-of-network bills, don't pay anything until you get an EOB. That's an explanation of benefits from your insurer. Compare that with the bills and confirm with your insurer that the providers are not, in fact, in your plan.
Then ask your provider if they'll settle for what the insurance company has already paid. Be persistent. You'll be surprised some doctors will negotiate with you.
You can also appeal to the Michigan Department of Insurance and Financial Services. John appealed. It's taken him a year, but he's finally seen a reduction in his bills.
You have to do your research. You have to really be a smart consumer.
Obviously, if you're having a life-threatening emergency, then is not the time to figure out what you're covered for. But if you do get a surprisingly high ER bill, be sure to ask questions of your provider and insurance company so you don't waste your money. I'm Joanne Purton, 7 Action News.